What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my kitchen, where safety is number one priority. And today, I'm going to put to the test meat gadgets. Let's see what I got this time. Heavy-duty meat tenderizer. Okay, let's stick one steak right here. And, whoa, look at that. It's going to tenderize it so well. I wish I had a wooden table. Oh, no way, it actually broke it off, I think. Gotta push it a bit. There you go. It's pulling it in. You do have to kind of push it forward, or otherwise it kind of spins through. Oh, you know what? Maybe this side here, what I'm supposed to push it with. If I push it with this thing, it goes through pretty good. I'm pretty sure this is New York strip. And it almost didn't have a problem. But wow, this is way too tenderized. Let me try to do this with pork. You know what, these pieces might be way too thick. So feed it too better. Cause maybe this is for thinner slices. I didn't get any thin slices. But you see, maybe it will work with chicken way better, because chicken might be a bit softer. Let me just open this all the way so you can see what's going on. Look, no! You see, it just kind of stuck. Let me pull it up and try to do the other side. That will work too. Don't stick your fingers in there. There you go. This side is just too thick or something. Man, it's a good idea, maybe for the smaller pieces of meat, but if you like a bigger pieces, it doesn't really work all the way. Or if you try to do it with New York strip, this is what you ended up with. Again, maybe way better this gadget with much, much thinner pieces. It probably will work. Let's try to run a chicken through here. Again, I doubt it will work because it's just too thick. But the chicken is a lot softer. Yeah, just breaking a piece off of it, as you can see. Yeah, no way. No big deal. We have another gadget right here. Hopefully it does way better and very, very easy. Opens up like that and there is a bunch of needles whenever it presses down like that. Whoa, look at that. Sharp. Whoa, that's easy. Kind of gets stuck on you a little bit, so you gotta hold it. Okay, the other side. Just don't tenderize your fingers. Wow, this is nice. Flip it over. Meat still gets sticky, so kinda don't push out as well. But once it's tenderized pretty good, it does push out much, much better. Wow, look at that. Can't complain about that. Really, really fast job. Look how many holes are there. It's pretty tenderized to me. In New York State, you don't wanna do more than that, I guess. And once you're done, put this away. Easy. Really cool gadget, thumbs up for me. But let's see what else I got. And this right here, instead of stabbing it, this one rolls it. Oh, very cool. So you press it and all these blades going to roll on you. This is kind of cool because hopefully it won't get stuck like the other one. It does holes, not bad. Kind of slides on me a little bit, so I'd have to hold it like that. I don't know, it's kind of unique. Maybe if my pork was much smaller, it would work a bit better. Probably best for the steak, not so much for the pork. Which is okay, I have here steak. Let's try to tenderize it. This is kind of doesn't tenderize because look what's happening. it just falls apart on me. So it doesn't really roll. I wish I would use the other gadget where I can just stab it like that instead. Instead of rolling it. It almost works better whenever I stab it like that. Rolling part does not work that well. Even though it's a good idea, first gadget, but it's like does the same stabbing a little bit better because it has a much, much bigger surface that it tenderizes the meat. So let me know in comments below what do you think about this gadget. Okay, those were really complicated and they kind of failed. So hopefully this simple one will make a much better job. Get my pork. Ah, slips on me. Look at that. Tenderize it so well. Just use your power, body weight. Look at those holes. Nice. You can probably bend on it like that too. If you really want to tenderize it much, much more, then swivel it. I don't know, I kind of like this gadget. Simple, but works. And also you can go like that too. But let's see what else I got. So I got here meat pounder for that. Hopefully it will work with chicken a lot better. And this is flat. That's heavy. Wow, really, really easy. I know what kind of chicken that is. It's kind of explodes on this side. Some kind of organic chicken that is cannot stay together. So weird. Oh well. Definitely does the job. Look how thin it is now. Bit of a too good of a job. But makes sense, right? If you have better chicken, hopefully it don't explode on you like that. But look how thin that is. Probably will work better with this pork. There you go. It works pretty good so far. You see this one I haven't done and it's stretched out so much. There you go. If you need to pound some meat, this meat pounder will do the job. But let's see if this meat tenderizer will be even better. It's a color circular one. This is also, what is it called, pork. Look at this hole side the way. You know what, probably make bunch of holes first on one side and then the other side. Super quickly, then use the pounder. Whoops. So that way it's even easier to make it really, really thin. Look at it. Together, these two tools work so good. Make it softer, then pound it. Yeah, you know what, if you do it together with these two tools, works way better as you can see. Look how much faster the same piece of meat have stretched out. So far these two gadgets combination is the best for tenderizing pork. So maybe then, just buy yourself one of these gadgets, 3-in-1. Instead of just having two pieces, this side here, let's open it up. Boom, the blade on this side. So you got the spikes on this side, flat one, and this side here, tenderized one. So 3-in-1 versus 2 right here. It is a little lighter, but you have more leverage. So I'm gonna make it tender with the spikes. And as you can see, it's not as big of a deal that it does not have this little plastic piece. Ooh. So, but it is nice to have that plastic piece because it push off the meat. This one sometimes gets stuck, you see? So, but anyways, it still works, kind of. If you put it to the side a bit, you see, it doesn't get stuck as bad. So that, I was hoping this gadget would have the same thing. But at the same time, it does still works. Now you can use this pounder. I'm definitely keeping this pounder quickly. Feel like you need more pounds right here. And even use this side. Make it even faster. Then flatten it out again. But you know what's for sure? Making holes in the fork first, like this. I still love this gadget. I probably would use this in combination with this and this. Look how well you can tenderize pork so much. Love it. Flip it over. Easy. You know what? This, maybe without that, I would probably never use this. But my favorite so far, the easiest, is this gadget. This gadget and this hammer together. Definitely keeping these two together. Because it works so well, effortless. And if I need to make like 6 of those, no problem, 15 minutes, I'm done. But guess what, I still have more. Check this out, one of these, it's on advertisement, it says for the steaks. Ooh, yeah, this is actually works the best. It doesn't spin on me, it doesn't slide on me, that's what I'm trying to say. Flip it over. Wow, this is nice. Especially for the steaks, when you don't need to tenderize it that much, like pork. This is cool. Very, very sharp. Awesome. So it's probably best to use it on a steak like that. When you don't need to tenderize it that much, just make a couple holes in. Boom, ready to go. Or this one, you just don't stab it as much. Overall, this is my favorite one. Tenderize it so well, so quickly. With steaks, you don't even have to do it that much. But this, you can pound it after. But you know what, I do still like this one because it's big. So that way it doesn't break off chunks. You hit it and it tenderizes flat, a big surface area. So you know what, so far, in combination, these two is my favorite tenderizer. Because whenever you make a bunch of holes, flip it over, same thing, quickly, then you pound it. Look how flat that is. Beautiful. So yeah, the best two right here. And one more thing, let's start with the chicken. Whoop, get stuck easily. There you go, only first time. Hopefully this chicken don't explode as much. I don't know what's on with this chicken. Power. Look how much it's widened it out. I wouldn't heat it anymore because this chicken just exploded. But look how flat that is already. Well guys, that's pretty much it. Let me know in comments below what do you think about this video. Don't forget to thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you next time.